matches. The winners of those matches will face each other next week for the right to face Brock Lesnar at SummerSlam for the Universal Championship. The first triple threat match will be Elias, Seth Rollins, and Bobby Lashley. The other triple threat match will be Drew McIntyre, Finn Balor, and Roman Reigns. I'm not done. And that match starts right now.
Here comes Roman.
Cover by Reigns. Roman Reigns is a step closer to SummerSlam.
Here's your winner, Roman Reigns.
Great timing by Elias.
Spear.
Better timing by Bobby.
Lashley covers. Bobby Lashley's got a date with Roman Reigns next week.
Here is your winner, Bobby Lashley.
Bobby. Lashley still standing, at least for now.
Went for the spear.
Oh, Lashley countered. Spear. Caught him. Cover by Reigns. Reigns is going to SummerSlam!
Here's your winner, Roman Reigns!
Roman Reigns gets his wish! A date with the Beast Brock Lesnar in 4 weeks! In
my heart and hope to die, taking this one step at a time. I got your back if you got mine. Oh, one foot in front of the other. One foot in front of the other.
So when you say one foot in front of the other, that usually means you're stepping forward, you're walking forward, you're not walking backwards. You're trying something new and you're walking forward. Do you get what I'm trying to say here? Welcome on in on the Soriano Network. Chris Soriano with you. Off the heels of a Monday Night Raw that saw Roman Reigns yet again earn a spot in the main event against Brock Lesnar at a high-end pay-per-view. I don't understand it. Now, when this whole issue came about with Brock and stripping of the title, many questions arose, and we thought to ourselves, we said, man, it can't be Roman again. It just can't. And I like Roman Reigns. I have nothing against him. I don't think he's as bad as the fans say he is. I think he's a good worker. I don't mind his matches. But at the end of the day, unfortunately, you have to listen to your fans. It's just not working. Him as a baby face and trying to push him as the new face of the company, it's just not working. A la Lex Luger 93. But back then, Vince had a quick hook on the Lex Express. You're not getting that this time around with Roman Reigns. Vince just keeps going back to it and going back to it and going back to it. Now, when this whole thing transpired and this whole storyline was going down, we thought maybe we were going to get the Lashley versus Lesnar showdown. And that's a dream match. You got to say that's a dream match. Two UFC guys in the WWE. That'd be great. And you heard about, you know, when Hogan got reinstated, that Lashley's going to win the title. It's going to be a black guy winning the title. Hogan's going to go out there, raise his hand. Oh, my God. And they're going to try and do that deal. Which I thought that would have, I don't think that would have turned over too well. Not Lashley winning the title, I wouldn't have had a problem with that, but Hogan coming out and doing that whole thing, I think it would have been too forced and it would have not been good for business. That being said, I was looking forward to Lashley and Lesnar. So when they had this whole triple threat thing and all that, and they had these matches, you looked at the matchups for the triple threats and you said, well, it's going to be definitely Lashley and most likely Roman. And that's what you got. So then when they had Lashley and Roman, you thought, okay, you know what? Maybe they'll do this. And I thought they were going to go down this route. Have the two of them end in a draw against each other. And then you set up a Lashley-Roman-Brock triple threat. Me, personally, how I would have booked it, fuck it. I would have booked Lashley winning straight up and having Lashley versus Lesnar. Now, I'm thinking Vince, and I'm trying to kind of appease Vince here and kind of go where Vince might go. So, you know what? Just do the triple threat. You can still have Roman in there, Vinny. Still have him in there. But at the end of the day, Lashley's going to be the one that goes over. Now you have Roman. And this is the thing to me that gets me. We talk about the WWE being predictable. Well, Roman and Lesnar is your main event. You know that's closing out the show. And you know that Brooklyn is going to boo Reigns out of the fucking building. You just know that. It's not going to be a good reception for him. You just know that. Who has the Money in the Bank briefcase? Braun Strowman. So 90% chance, folks, this is what's going to happen. Roman Reigns will finally defeat Brock Lesnar one-on-one. And then Braun will come out and kick the shit out of Roman and win the title. I don't see Roman losing again because really, what's the point? If you're going to put Roman in the match, you might as well have him finally win. Finally. Don't have him lose. Have him win finally and then have Braun come out and squash him. Because we all know that's what's going to happen. Bad thing is, though, that you know now Braun will be the heel, Roman will be the babyface, because we can't obviously change roles because we want Roman to be the face. But it just, I don't understand really why you keep going back to that same formula that's not working. It's just not working. And I'm not saying you would have had to put a guy in there that was a string bean. I know Vince loves his big guys. You could have put Bobby in there. You could have easily put Lashley in there. And I thought it would have been a great match. And Roman and Brock may be a good match. Don't get me wrong. Cause I don't think Roman's that bad of a wrestler. I really don't think that he's that bad of a worker. I really don't. I don't think he's that bad as people say he is. That being said, it kind of turns me off, and I'm kind of uninterested when I'm sitting there watching a main event and they're booing from start to finish. But see, that's the world that we live in now, folks. And I don't mean this to turn this into a political thing. But the people on the left think that they could just boo and scream and this and that, and that's going to get Donald Trump out of the White House. It's just not the case. You got to vote. Now, the thing is with the WWE, that's different. Obviously, it's not politics and the world leader being elected and everything. But the difference is you can take action and not go and not watch. Their ratings have been shit for years. They're still making money. Roman Reigns t-shirts are still selling. House show attendance is still good. If you want to really make an impact, you got to make an impact. And I tell this all the time with people on the left about Donald Trump. Booing and hissing and crying and whining and bitching and moaning and, you know, pissing on a Hollywood star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame and smashing it to pieces and, you know, just all this crazy shit. That's not going to get Donald Trump out of the White House. And it may actually get him reelected. What you have to do is stop acting like an asshole and then take action when it comes time for you to take action. The fact that Roman Reigns is still out there and his merchandise is selling well, and the house show attendance is up, and television ratings are, I mean, they're not abysmal for a wrestling program nowadays in 2018. I mean, let's be honest, they're not abysmal. Network subscriptions are still up. Hit them where it hurts. If you really, really are so offended by Roman Reigns, then do something. But sitting there booing and trying to hijack the show, it's just not going to work because Vince doesn't give a fuck at this point. He doesn't give a fuck. You want to boo? I'll put him out there even more. It's not your company yet, Paul. Oh, man. But Lesnar, Roman, what? This is what, round nine? I mean, we used to make fun of the Big Show and Brock. Now we're getting Brock and Roman for the millionth time.